Hey there, how was doing? This is Kali from TechFans here. So in this video, we will be taking a look at latest Zen UI Android Pi beta on Asus Zenfone Lite L1. Not only for Lite 1, it also for Live L1 and Live L2. We already made a video on how to install it. So if you want to install, please use the I button which appears right now. So no issues. Well, let's get started. I just want this video to be crisp and real quick. So first we talk about the upgrades or features that you get after installing this. First, the number update. It's 8.0 to 9.0 pi, and the important thing that is the navigation bar. You will get the quick switch navigation bar. You have option to enable it, also the pi recents and swipe switching. Third, the night light option. We have talked about the splendid in the disadvantages video. Now they have added that feature. You can turn on it, also set it to automatic. Face unlock is little faster than the Oreo. Most of the time it's working like a charm. Also there is a slight improvement in terms of audio quality. It's little louder and crisper. This is not a feature, but the devs have merged the builds for all the three devices. So there is single kernel and vendor, so the updates would be fast. Also, we are getting little large number of devices in the group. It's really great for everyone. And I have to talk about AI feature here. In the device they have added it, but only for ringing audio. The flagship devices, like my personal favorite 5Z, is entirely works with tons of AI algorithms. Here it's not gonna play main role, but they have created the base. Slight improvement on battery backup while comparing to Oreo builds. You might get extra 10 to 15 minutes of SOT. Also, they have introduced the Asus data transfer, which helps you to improve stuffs like moving from one to other world device. The great thing is they have included entire Zen Motion concept. So double tap to wake up is there, but the great, it does its job at the end of the day. In most of the time, distress number issue is now gone, at least not appearing. These are some of the feature upgrades in this Pi beta. Still, there might be some other features like FinApp, but please let me know if I missed any. I forgot there is an option to enable dark mode in dev options, but it only darkens the settings. Also I have to let you know that you can darken the Asus native apps like messages and phone manually in the app settings. Now we come to the serious part, the bugs and issues. First of all, I have to appreciate the team for the build that they made and they gave. Whatever issues I have mentioned in the Zen UI disadvantages video, they have fixed most of them, not entirely, but some of them got resolved. So great thanks. The first issue is the status bar day and date. It's on the brightness slider, looks little annoying. Reasons: it's not buttery smooth, it glitches most of the time. Also, the frames really get stuck most of the time. App management: it's still the worst. It's not even capable of keeping two apps in the background. I know to feel fast, they have rapidly clearing the RAM. It also improves the battery performance, but it's really worst when I try to make a payments from one side to another side. So it's really not good. The permission control. The permission tab is entirely broken for some time, I guess. So it won't ask for any permission. You have to enable it manually for each and every app that you install. So if you found any app is not working, just update or check the permission. Is it enabled or not? I have to admit that there are some apps not working in Pi beta even after giving the permission. For example, the Lightroom, it's not working, but most of the day-to-day apps are working fine, no issues. Bigger toggles. In settings, some toggles are really big and huge. It looks weird when text or other things are in low DPI. I really thought Asus bring the digital well-being in Android Pi, but that's not in beta. Maybe in stable version or else in Android Q, God only knows. But if they would have included it, I would really happy about it. Anyway, still there are some bugs like rounded corner curve, but I don't want to get into the small things. But this build is nearly close to stable build, as Asus makes these stable builds like beta. So that's what about this video. Performance and all is same. You guys are asking to make a video on lot of things. I will be doing it one by one, as I'm working for this only on Saturday and Sunday. You guys also were asking about PUBG, so I have not installed the PUBG, but I have installed the PUBG Lite. It's not working up to the mark. It's most of the time it just glitch and lags. So yeah, because I don't even have the space to install the PUBG, but I installed the PUBG Lite on Lite L1. So that's what about this video. Leave a like if you like my work and subscribe to this channel to show your support. Videos will be keep coming. Thank you for watching. Code Moto. You think by now.